Hi guys, it's me Karen and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to do a page in this book here, The Dimensions by, and I'm not going to pronounce that right, so I'm going to go over here. And it's Francois Gautier. Anyway, we're going to do this page here. I know I had picked another page out, but this was also another page I wanted to try. So I'm going to do it in the Derwent Artist pencils. So I'm going to pick out some of these blue colors and some gray colors. The whales are like the humpback whales. Big little dudes. And we're in the sky, so our reflection isn't going to be like in the blue water. It's going to be more of a dark coloration. In the water, they have kind of a blue hue to them because the water itself is that color. So they're lighter on the belly, around the bottom of their fins, underside of the fins, and kind of around the eye. But the rest of it is dark coloration. So we're going to go with some of these dark grayish blue tones for the backside, but we're also going to add gray into them, or even maybe some of these dark green areas. Our gray tone is not all that much in this set. They do have a blue gray, which I probably will use. I like that. That would be, oops, not back that far. Okay, we'll pull that out. I haven't used these pencils yet, so I mean, other than color that pony, but there's a bunch of brown tones, just pulled them out. So that blue gray, we'll go with the ivory black just because it's going to be our kind of black tone. Grays are not in here, really. Gunmetal might work. Pull it out just for fun. Storm gray. Okay, then we're going to go back to the blue section and pull out, like, the indigo has got enough of the darker color in it. Just have to find it. It's in the blues. Midnight blue. What does midnight blue look like? No, oh, sorry about the car. Where is midnight blue? That might work. We'll pull that one out too. Midnight indigo. This blue ash. Where do I find blue ash at? It was right after indigo. Here we go. I'm kind of liking this fir green as kind of a gray tone. Gotta find it. Okay. Spruce green might work too. Spruce green. And then it's like a pure white, so we'll get the sky blue out. Let's melt sky blue. And then the white champagne. It's too yellow. Pink is too pink. What do we got on the other side here? You get to see how I pick out colors. This silver gray. It's a good one too. And then the Chinese white. We'll see how that works. Okay. There are my colors. And we might pull out some. Might not. I don't know. We're just going to try to work with this selection of coloration for the whales. You notice how many pencils I have out here to color this little itty bitty little guys. But we're going to try layering to make sure we get a coloration that is kind of close. And why not? We'll just start with this big guy here. Let's see. We'll go in with our grayish colors that we have here. Start off with the blue-gray. And we're going to add this kind of on his back. Very lightly, because I really don't know how these work on this kind of paper. And we have kind of this distinctive line here. The eye has got more white, so we're just going to bring that blue up to a certain area and kind of go around that eye. Has that grayish color kind of coming down this way, but it's more white towards the back. Go up the nose a little, keeping the tip a little lighter. Coming down this way. And the top of his fin here. Some of that in there, his tail. Give him some wrinkles here. They're not the smoothest looking animals. Thank you. Okay, on his belly, we're going to add, we didn't do this little guy over here. On his belly, we're going to add a little of this blue too. Because we have shadows here already down for us, and we're just going to put blue on those instead of the gray. Defining the valley part of the hill and valley area. So we're darkening the ones that come down, not up. We'll leave those as a highlighted area. So we don't want to put any color on those yet. But the darker ones, we can go a little darker and bring them out. Especially by the turn here, because he's going under the umbrella, or under the balloon, and then coming out. So we want to darken that and the little parts that you can see under the balloon. Okay. Turning him gray instead, or a darker blue instead of the gray color that's there. So we want to layer up our colors. We're going to bring in the silver gray. A little lighter color. Blend out that blue that we have here. I'm running this color on top. We'll lighten it to make it more of a gray instead of a blue. Keep the colors out that I was using. This one here is the storm gray. The gunmetal's coming in now. Gonna get a little point on that. I'm gonna do a little more work around his eyeball here. I'm gonna bring some of that darkness in there. Around there. Outlining his lip area there. And just keep in mind, I'm using a very light pressure. Till I figure out how these pencils really work, I want to keep it light. It goes up here. I picked out a lot of pencils. We may not use them all. We're going to bring in the fur green that I liked. Adding in a little of the green to the grays. Don't see much color in the eye. outline it. Up here too. Again, I'm just using this very lightly. Really trying not to put much pressure on it. But it is black, so keep that in mind. Okay, I'll bring in the white. We'll see if the white pencil will do what I hope it will do. It's a really light white. Let's see. I'm used to my Holbein white. I want it to put down some color. This is going to be, I think, too light for me. So I'm going to go in here. With the Holbein white and add in the white areas that I want. Thank you. Gonna buck a little bit. I know, not much color to him, but I'm going to remember what he is. I think I will add the bit of indigo that I wanted to add. Yeah. Okay. Little like bumps on him. We're gonna do in kind of a gunmetal color. Sharpen it. Just kind of go around them on one side. Considering this is a dimensional book, we want to keep that on one side only, I would assume. Have to use black on some of those. Bubbles are something different. Okay, this guy's shadow thingy is here. This guy's shadow thingy was in here. And of course our big shadow there. I'm gonna go up in here and put some of this gray in the water spray. It's because we need color in there. Got a sharp point down there and it's making lines, but we'll blur that out. Silver gray. So we didn't end up using these, moving those over to the side. Narrowed it down to all these little colors. So I'll be coloring all the little dudes that color. We're going to add in white in here, probably with Posca. And if I have one, I will sit here and do his eye with it. What do I have? Here's Posca. Got out all the white pens. So if the white pit pen, that's not the one I want. I've got a set of them, so I like the brush tip. Okay, I'm gonna use the brush tip here, just on the tip of his fins. His eye. Sakura pen here, just to try to get some highlight. In the, I don't know what these are, barnacle type things. going to work with that. Just going to bring that out just a little bit more. Same with this one. Trace over that line. Boom. Got him done. Oh, his tail. I forgot his tail. Well, I forgot his tail. We didn't. That's interesting. Just soaking right into the black. Yep, I gotta wait for that to dry. White Holbein. We'll have to do that on the other side later. Okay. Baskets. We can do at least a basket here. I don't know how long this video has been, but we need browns. Then we'll just do a basket real quick. Find the brown section. Do-do-do-do. Brown, light ochre, golden brown, and whatever you are, copper beech. Sorry, it's brown tones, light brown tone down to a dark brown tone, hopefully. So, basket, might as well get you down for that, it's tiny. Just trying to get it to lock on that basket. Okay, this is the light ochre. Golden brown. Bronze. Kind of took out something called brown, but I don't know if I did. This looks dark. What is this? This one is a copper beech. And burnt umber. We'll go back in with the golden brown. Black, we have out somewhere. And we're just going to trace over these basket lines. And what are these sandbags? There we go, a basket. I don't know, the balloon. Why not try some reds, some deep reds? Do we have any deep reds? We have mahogany, which is a kind of an orange color. I'll try that. Red-ish color. What do we have? Ooh, burnt carmine's pretty. We could find it. Burnt carmine should have been with the chocolate. I didn't know I had a chocolate. Burnt carmine's missing. I may have put it someplace else. Because chocolate's there. Let's see. The reds. Plum won't work. These two might. And a light. I guess the burnt rose might work. I'll have to find that other pencil. Anyway, here we go. Kind of a reddish balloon. I pull out the burnt rose first, and we're going to put that down as a highlight. I'm going to try to put that down as a highlight without making it all streaky. Reminds me of Victorian velvet. It's a pretty color. Okay, next color. I believe this is the wine, and I can't pronounce that, so it's a pencil 1810. Whatever color this is, matte or carmine. Okay, go back in with the burnt rose. You guys gotta quit rolling. Go the other direction. Okay, we're gonna bring in, let's see, what color did we not use? I used that one. Yeah, I used that one, I thought. The mahogany I didn't use. Going to bring in a little bit of an orange. I need another color. Okay, bread and burnt carmine, I found it. It's the one I wanted, so I'm gonna bring that color down a little bit. Sorry, you're still using light pressure on this. It's just a darker pencil. A little heavier here to put that shadow back in. There we go. Let's see. Gonna bring in our brush pen. that was just the brush pen, a little bit of the white. Holbein here. Then bring back in the ash or burnt rose or whatever it is, the burnt rose. Okay, there we go. We got one done. Add a little of that rose down in here. Darken that just a bit more. I want to highlight, but keep playing with this forever. Anyway, that'll be it for this part. We got one little whale done. I'm going to wait to do the water up here until the next episode. I'm going to try to add just a little bit more. White here. The white or the red is prominent color. It will pick up this. We'll get a pink tone in the white is what I'm saying. Can't say it, but it's what I meant. There we go. Okay, I'll take a picture and leave it at the end of the video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section down below. I'll try to leave links to all the pencils I used down there also. I have to darken up some of these. It's about a pencil length away. It's right about in here. It's shadow. It's got one there somewhere. What am I using here? I'm using indigo. Darken this shadow up a little bit. There we go. Anyway, I will see you in the next part. I hope you all enjoyed. I'll leave links down in the description box along with all the pencils I used. Take care, everyone. Bye now.